Hey, welcome back, class. Now let's take these blocks that we just configured and connect them together, assemble them together to make a duck. And that's our goal. So we'll use the snap mode, which is what you use when connecting objects via the mate connectors that appear on each of the parts. And we'll use the assembly tab, which is where you assemble parts together. And there's a generation button that you use to generate the items that you want to import into the assembly, okay? So let's see if this works. So we have the insert option, select the part, and then generate. And so I'm going to go and scroll right down to the actual object, and it looks like that. Now, the one question I have is I wonder if the first part is connected to the origin. Let's see here. Is this connected to the origin? So let's see here. Let's double check it. Let's go big. Let's go insert. They're picking on the right part. And they generate it. You click on it. And then green check mark. One more time. So it doesn't look like they connect it to the origin. Mm-mm. Right, awesome. What about the next section? So there they go. They fix it there. Okay, I get it. All right, so let's do this. So we've got this shape right here. So we start with this plate here. It's like a 2x3. And then we'll work our way up 2x3 and get these parts here. So let's give it a shot. So I'm going to make this part, this shape right here. Let's head on over to the, Let's go here. I guess I can close this out. And let's go to the assembly tab, which is here. Let's go to insert, there's part studio. We've got these parts here. It says brick. We actually want a plate, right? We want a plate. We want a 2x3. And red is the right color. Let's generate. Here it gives you a preview here. See that? Now that's a plate. What's it look like if it's a tile? Doesn't give me the right one. So let's go plate. I think that's the right one. Let's go generate. Try it one more time. I click generate and I think I have to click on the part. There it is. And we'll left click somewhere or just green. Yeah, the green check mark. That's right. So there it is. That's the actual plate. Excellent. So now I'm going to create these other. Looks like there's another plate that's a 2x3. Looks like it's a 2x3 here as well. See that? It could be maybe a 2x2. Let's double check here. Nope, it's a 2x3. I see it. So let's add another 2x3 here. Let's go to insert. 2x3. And it's a red plate. Let's generate it. Click here. And green check mark. So I wonder if it ended up on the same spot. Yeah, it did. So I had to move it out there. Okay. Now let's do the same kind of thing. We've got all these other parts. We've got these, looks like two by twos, right? So two by twos. Let's go insert. Oh, you know what I need to do? I need to fix this. I forgot about that. This particular one here, we want to fix it. So this plate right here, see that one, this one, we want to fix that. So we want to right click on that and hit fix. So that one's stationary. Now this one can't be moved. You see it? That's why you've got this icon says the part is fixed. Insert. Let's go to now a brick type. We've got two by twos, and they're yellow. Let's go generate. Let's click once. We've inserted one. And let's do it again. We've got two. Awesome. And instead of going to the green check mark, I'm going to keep adding. We can keep changing them. This is a, we've got this plate down here. Now this looks like a 2x4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 2x4 yellow. Yeah, 2x4 yellow. 2x4 yellow brick. Let's generate it. Let's click on it. There you go. And I'm going to click it over here somewhere. And this one down here looks like a 1x2. It is a 1x2. Let's double check. Is there a 1x2 somewhere? Yeah, there's a 1x2 right here. See it? That is a 1x2. It says yellow brick, 1x2. Okay, so 1x2. It's a brick. 1x2. Let's generate. Let's click. And click. All right, excellent. So I've got all the parts. Now let's start merging them together. And interesting, how are these going to merge? Let's see. Well, let's give it a shot here. Let's see what they describe in the mating process. I'm kind of curious. Let's see what they use to mate these together. Mm-hmm. So it looks like, you see they click there, good, they're clicking on the bottom. And Q is to rotate, all right, great. I've also used that option here. So I'm gonna read these directions. It says left click the snap mode tool to turn it on, left click and hold on one of the mate connectors. Drag your cursor and brick while still holding the left mouse over one of the middle pegs on the red plate so that the new mate connector icon shows up by your mouse. Press the Q to rotate the brick until it lines up with both pegs. Let go of the left mouse button. Left click the green. So the option here is left click and hold it. And these mate connectors are activated. So you're not really searching for them. You're not searching for them. They're just activated. And so it appears that these should work A-OK. Keep my fingers crossed, see if they do. But let's give it a shot. So, okay, the first things first. We're going to take, let me just screen check mark this. Got all these parts. We're going to take this mate connector here. We're going to follow those directions. Just to choose the fasten mate. Alrighty. Okay. There we go. Then it says drag your cursor. Well, actually it says it's going to be this one right here, I think. Let's see. That's the bottom one. We'll choose this little mate connector right here, this one here. And I'm going to left click on it. That's what it says to do. Left click and hold. Okay, that's the one I chose. And then it says drag your cursor over one of the middle pegs. Now, you notice that I released it. That's okay, because I'm trying to get into that right position. but it says to drag it, let's choose it one more time, make connector, click there till we hover over this. Okay, and I don't see it activating like it does on the video. So I chose Q and my window is thinking. So nothing happened there. So let's try it one more time. Connector. Okay, there we go. So I didn't really choose their method. I kind of had to select them twice. I had to do it a little differently. And it looks like it's, yeah, ooh. Not working well. So I'm just going to cancel that and try it again. Okay, so give me 1 second. All right, so let's see if I can find some of these make connectors. I have these automated make connectors that are showing up. But I'm going to try something here. I'm going to go to Fasten Mate. I'm going to hover over the surface here. And again, I'm not sure which mate connector I'm trying to utilize. This one seems like it's a little off. I'll be honest. It's a little too deep. So I don't think it's the right connector. So I'm going to hover over the plate here. And I see a mate connector here that I like. Right there. Let's just try that again. Let's try that again here. This hover there. See that white one right there? I'm going to hold down the shift. That one right there is the one I want. I'm going to select that one. And then what I'm going to do is that particular mate connector, I'm going to attach it to this here. And hopefully there is a center mate connector on this region here. Let's see. So I don't know if I see one here. Let's see. Ooh-hoo. And it looks like there's one here. Yeah, I don't see it. Let's use this one here. Let's see if that one activates. Hopefully this is the right one. Choose it. Let's see what happens here. Let's zoom back out. And it looks like there's some overlap. See how it's inside the object? That's what you don't want. Definitely don't want, I don't want that. There is definite overlap there, and that's not what we need. Let me hit the solve button. Nope. Let's see, rotate. Let's accept it and see what we need to do. Yeah, so that's not correct. So I'm going to have to adjust these mate connectors, and I'll be right back with an explanation. So after thinking about it, I think I know why. I want the mate connector that's on top of the cylinder. I chose the face of the tile that's been extruded, but not the top of the cylinder. So let me just delete this here and fix that. So let's delete that mate connector. Let's drag this over to the right just a hair. And here's what I want to choose. I want to choose the top of that. So let's do that. Let's go mate connector. It's a rigid connection. Let's go here. There it is, the top. Shift, hold that down. And then let's go back to the bottom here. Choose that one there. And that is it. Now let's rotate. And it's perfect. Now there's, if I choose Q on the keyboard, does that rotate? Yeah. So Q also rotates. See that? Nice. Perfect. And accept. All right, we got it. Good. So a couple of errors on my part, but we modified that. Just there's quite a few of these mate connectors floating around, but that's nice. If you wanted to check and see if there's any interference, you can just check that out right there and see that. It looks pretty a-okay. All right, great. Now, what else are we going to connect? Let's just start whipping right along here. Got this this one here. Mm-hmm. Looks like it's the second row on that 2x4, so I can do that. Let's just get this out of the way here. Move some of these things out of here. And it's this 2x4 here. And that's going to be connected here. Okay, good. So, all right. Let's go to fastener. Rigid fastener. Let's click on the top there. That's it. Let's double check. Yep. First one. Now let's go here. I think we're going to click on this one right there. That's the one. Yep. Let's check it out, see where we're at. And again, it looks kind of busy. Looks like a good connection. Okay, let's accept that. Now I want to connect this other 2x2 directly on this edge. Let's go, let's click on this top portion here. And then now let's take this here. I believe it's going to be that one there. Yep. Looks like it's proper. Let's accept that one. And now let's go back to this red plate. And connect that on top of here. Let's double check, make sure that's right. Yep. And on that top plate, we're going to attach this here. I chose that corner, so it'll be this corner here. Right there. And finally, this piece here. Okay, we'll choose. This top half right there. And then now corner right here. Let's see what it looks like. I think that's it. Now, how do you hide all of these these mate connectors that are everywhere? That's a good question. I don't know how to do that yet, but let me figure that out and show you. So give me just 1 second here. See if I can figure that out. Hey, here it is. So at the bottom of the screen here, for the directions, which are awesome, by the way, on this tutorial, it says keyboard shortcut. You can toggle the visibility of your mate connectors with the K on the keyboard. So what I'll do is left click and drag. Let's try that again. Left click and drag. Select all of your items. And then select K on the keyboard, and there you have it. Everything disappeared. All the mate connectors disappeared. That works perfect. Awesome. All right, well, that was the building block section, and we'll take a look at the last section called instruction manual. So like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.